In the slum of a dusty town called Kurumani, in the department of Sesar, 25 small-scale farming families have lived for nearly 3 years after being displaced from the village of Pitalito. They do not have access to land and therefore cannot grow crops. Nor is there alternative employment in Kurumani for these families, who have always worked the fields. Don Pedro is one of the community leaders. He's been displaced 3 times.
Tengo 57 años y los momentos más difíciles que he podido vivir han sido estos 3 años que llevo desplazado aquí en Kurumani.
El marido mío tiene que trabajar el jornal. Se gana 20,000 pesos. Ahorita que lo subieron. Pero 20,000 pesos no alcanzan para mantener 3 niños. Cinco de la familia.
La guerra ha sido muy dura por acá, en el Cesar. Han habido muchas muertes, masacres y, pues, como muchos sabemos, uno lo somete el temor y también el amor a la familia, porque nuestros hijos son nuestra vida y sabemos que hay que protegerlos a ellos. Por ese motivo, nosotros aceptamos salir desplazados de allí.
Esto es lo que hago yo ahora después del desplazamiento, lo que hago es esto.
Esther was a professor in Pitalito and responsible for the education of 27 children who were studying at the school. She now cooks and sells soup for 1,000 Colombian pesos to support her 2 sons. This earns her about $11 a day. Esther is an important leader for the community, and as is the case for many other leaders in Colombia, she has been the target of threats and intimidation. In February of this year, the Committee in Solidarity with Political Prisoners and the legal team of the people, who have supported and advised these displaced families during the past 2 years, reported the presence of a hooded man who entered her home.
Vamos a retornar, aunque nos cueste, o sea, si nos cueste la vida, porque realmente estamos viviendo mal, en unas condiciones precarias que aquí se puede ver. Y la vida de nosotros es el campo.
After the displacement, the family camped for a month in this place, and later, hoping to draw attention to their situation, they set up shacks in this park, where they stayed for over a month. Esther recalls that many children became ill because of the rain and difficult conditions where they slept. Since then, with her 2 sons and her partner, they share this small room. We went with Don Pedro to Pitalito, which is about 45 minutes away from Kurumani, in order to verify the conditions for a possible return to the land. PBI accompanied the committee in solidarity with political prisoners in this trip. Don Pedro explains where the farms of the displaced families were located, and how the families could feed themselves during the first months of a possible return. There is no longer a trace of their farms, nor of their crops, and it is clear they would have to start from scratch.
Eso es la luna de ahí para allá. Es Pitalito también.
The committee, along with the legal team of the people, has researched this case of internal displacement. The community had lived in Pitalito for over 25 years when a landowner allegedly bought their farms by force, as the displaced families later reported to the authorities. As reported by the committee and the legal team of the people, in June 2010, the community was forced from its territory as a result of an illegal eviction.
Esta es una comunidad que fue desplazada fuertemente, violentamente, desde junio del año 2010 por funcionarios del Ejército Nacional, quienes, cumpliendo órdenes o cumpliendo directivas para defender los intereses de un latifundista, los despoja o los desaloja de la región.
Eso, primer robo, ahora el segundo.
Plata, ¿qué más les quitaron?
The return of the families is just one step in a long struggle to restore their lands. The committee and the legal team of the people are responsible for the legal work necessary to achieve the allocation of land titles. And the lawyers travel to Kurumani every month to talk with the community, receive their testimonies and advise them on the return process.
Somos claros, somos conscientes que tenemos que hacer un análisis desde el punto de vista de cuál es la situación jurídica del predio y de las familias, por supuesto. Creo que las familias van a acudir a la ley de víctimas y de restitución de tierras. En este momento está planteado así y se debe acudir y se debe inscribir los predios.
Approximately 10% of the Colombian population has been displaced by violence. Consequently, land restitution is one of the most important steps towards lasting peace in Colombia.
¿Qué le pido yo? Justicia. Que ya no se hagan los sordos y que no se hagan los inocentes. Que no cierren los oídos y sobre todo que respondan.
Que nos escuchen, porque no es posible que nosotros no merecemos estar en esta situación tan crítica que tenemos.
Creo que el ejemplo Pitalito debe ser conocido en Colombia. Este es un caso que debe analizarse desde diferentes perspectivas. Aquí vamos a mirar qué tan efectiva es la ley de víctimas en Colombia.